If tears could build a staircase and memory lane and walk just where you are to bring you home again. Although it seems difficult to see you beyond your sorrow, may you look back in memories to comfort you tomorrow. Of September 1994, the union between the V. Nelson Powell, Air Soul, Rest in Peace, and Luca Powell produced a baby girl, Shanita Amar Powell. This little bundle of joy grew into a young woman, otherwise called as Yovie. Yovie, by her family members and her friends. Dovie, by her in-laws and associates. Lovey by
Ernie Wonderful Gaspar. From the Arthritis Woman Suppliers, I just want to send our sincere condolences to the extended family of Shanika Powell Blake at the Pike United Church in Manchester. You know, we just want to lay her to rest today in proper way, in fine style.
My Powell Blake, whose life seems to have been coming together nicely as she has just gotten married. She had a future that seems bright. Suddenly, sickness reared its ugly head, and without warning, a wife, a mother, a sister, an aunt and a friend was taken away, leaving behind, to mourn her passing, husband Vincent Blake and her six children. Father Luca Powell, stepmother, sisters, brothers, uncles, aunts, nieces, nephews, relatives, other relatives, and friends. Sleep on Dovie, sleep on Yovie, sleep on Lovie, Steph, Shanika, Amoy, Powell, Blake, sleep on and take care of us. Thank you.
On behalf of the Pike Primary and Infant School, I would like to express our sincere condolences to the bereaved family of Mrs. Shanika Powell Blake, to her husband, Mr. Vestin Blake, and all her children. Those we met were Lamar in grade 4, Alia in grade 2, Shansi at infant 2, and Shantana at infant 1. She was a very humble, pleasant, and to ensure her children receive quality education. Our hearts are saddened and ached for the sudden passing of a loving soul. Please be comforted by Psalm 34, verse 18. The Lord is near to the brokenhearted and saves the crushed in spirit. Psalm 73, verse 26. My flesh and my heart faileth, but God is the strength of my heart and my portion forever. On behalf of the principal of the Lower Primary and Infant, Dr. Samuels, and our vice principal, Mrs. Madeline Brown, who is unavoidably absent due to illness, we just want to extend our sincere condolences to the family, and also we are here in support of Javier Linton, who is currently a student at our school in grade 6. You have our support, and we have been supporting Javier since the passing of her mother. So we just want to extend our heartiest condolences, and we know that God had only lent us to her for a short while, and despite being 29 years, we know that she had lived the life that God has desired for her. And at this time, we just have a group of students from her class to do a night.
I am Ajayla Nicole, the head girl of Lower River Primary and Infant School. To Javier and family, on behalf of the entire school family of Lower River Primary and Infant School, we just want to share a few words of encouragement to you all. Words can't express how deeply sorry we are for the loss of your mom, who was also a sister, an aunt, a friend. She must have been an amazing woman to raise someone as wonderful as you. At this difficult time, please know that you are not alone. Even though your mom is gone, the love she had for you all will forever be in your heart. Hold on to those memories and let them be a source of strength and comfort.
We are all here for you, Javier. If you ever need someone to talk to, a shoulder to cry on, or just a distraction, please don't hesitate to reach out. We will support you in any way we can. Your mom will be deeply missed, but her memory will live on through you and your siblings. Javier, your mom raised a strong, kind, and compassionate person, and I know you will continue to make her proud.
With the deepest sympathy, your school family.
And at this time, I'll just ask Mrs. Lynch, who is her class teacher, to make an address.
Javier is just a very brilliant student, very loving. I met her mom on the phone recently in December. She called to say, Mrs. Lynch, I will be moving from Trelawney and I will be taking Javier with me. And then she called to say, you know, she is in grade 6, will be doing her exams. So I'm going to wait until after exams, then I will take her. And when we spoke over the phone, she was such an intelligent person. I was saying, you know, I know she attended Low River School some time ago, but I just can't remember. I seen her in person, then I'm sure I would, you know, remember her. But just know that we love Javier very much. Other teachers wanted to be here, but they, you know, circumstances, they couldn't be here. But just know that our prayers are with the family.
excited to be here because I was in the hospital with Sister Powell. And to be honest, she's my friend. Till death do us part, she's my friend. And you know, I asked the doctor, I'm in and out of the hospital, and I asked the doctor yesterday, I want to go to funeral today. He said, why Miss Paul? He said, he's my good friend. And she prayed to God before she part this life. She prayed. Me and I have good time and had a nurses and workers in the hospital. Good time praying. Because, you know, sometimes we don't know the word and it seems like nice, just think. And believe you me, she make up her minds that she knows that she about it. Can tell me everything, every secret thing. We know it. I feel me any business that I got. And I will never let her down in her sin. I fear. Praise God. When I see the doctor run from her, the nurses them run, when this thing of death take her, I believe you me, she fell on the floor. I held on to her. She said, minister, which when I'm not a minister, you know, can I sing and pray? I got a female girl, Tina, the hospital, I'm going to come out. I believe you me, when she's on the floor here, I sat off my bed. It's the first I ever come off of my bed. And I sat down there with her in my lap. And she held my hand and said, the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. That is what carried her home. And the bread left her body. They tell me not to hold her. I say, I have to hold her. But if you're a doctor, I'm a prayer warrior. Which one powerful more? And I asked doctor yesterday to make me here. So on behalf of myself and my home group, and had a world-class family over in Chimani here. Condolences to the family, the Blake family. Daddy, she loves you much too. Talk about you a lot.
Christmas Eve, going home to see her mama and her daddy with the baby in the back seat. 50 miles to go and she was running low on faith and gasoline. It'd been a long, hard year. She had a lot on her mind and she didn't pay attention. She was going away too fast. And before she knew it, she was spinning on a thin black sheet of glass. She saw both their lives flash before her eyes. She didn't even have time to cry. She was so scared. She threw her hands up in the air. Jesus, take the wheel.
to heal every hurt and right every wrong. Within you right now, come and turn this around. Deep down I know this world isn't home. Come, Jesus, come. There'll be no war, and there'll be no chains when Jesus comes. Let today be the day you conquer the weak and the strong just the same, and all will believe in the power of his name.
Goodbye's the same.
Come closer, man, closer.
She's your bride. Come on, come on. Where are we?
This
is your bride. Are your wife?
Are you running for the marriage?
The legal boss, man.
You're running for your wife, man. Oh, man. Because number one, you know, I respect that. They all start to see you. Woo!